Welcome to video 3 on how Transport Fever 2 can be used as a simulator for your model railway. In this episode, let's have a closer look at stations. This is where we were at the end of video 2. And well, before laying all this track, it is a wise thing to have in mind that trains can only stop or a scheduled stop at a station, or more precisely at a platform. And well, we have to figure out where we need these platforms. There are two types of platforms. You can have cargo platforms, and that is where the cargo trains can make a scheduled stop. And there are passenger platforms, where the passenger trains can make a scheduled stop and cargo trains cannot. So let's have an examination of our intended layout and the intended train traffic. I plan to drive 3 trains on this small layout. There's a passenger train running counterclockwise, and it at station south, it should have a platform over here to be able to make its scheduled stop. And at station north, we need a passenger platform over there too. Then there is a clockwise passenger train. At station north, it needs its passenger platform. And also at station south, we need to create a passenger platform. Then there is a cargo train. It runs at the North Industry all the way to the other North Industry. So two cargo platforms over there, and at station south, it's okay, it can just run through that station without a stop. Or maybe it has to stop because there's traffic in the curve, but that's not a scheduled stop. Let's see how we can create these platforms. Alright, so we were happily laying track, but it is a good plan to first place our stations. A passenger station with two platforms here at south. So let's try to find it here in the building tab. I get a station at my cursor position. That's okay. It's a one-track station. That is because over here I can select the number of tracks, and I can also select the length and standard or high speed track and electrification. Well, I want a 3-track station and maybe not too long, 120 meters. It does not have the correct orientation. That is easily changed by pressing the M or the N key. That is a rotation course. You can also press the shift key and then make finer steps. This seems to be the correct orientation. The 3 tracks though, that configuration is not what I want. I want 3 adjacent tracks. But that is not a big problem because we can edit any station after having placed it. So maybe I best take a 2-track station, then I have less editing to do. Now I also find out that I cannot connect it because my tracks are too long. I have to make my tracks such that they end here, more or less here at this little bush. So let's first do that. Let me click the bulldozer and take away all the track. Then I can simply place my station, because probably these turnouts have to be done again also. Alright, this looks good. Empty space, place a station, this one, the 2-track station, and it should be somewhere over here. This looks good. Can I reach it with this track? That's the only question. Well, let's, before we continue, check if that works. Yeah, there's a little extra bend, a little extra curve here, but I don't really mind. I could have placed my station a little nicer, but this curve is small enough to be okay. Let's first edit the station such that this platform here is gone and there are 3 tracks. That can be done by simply leaving placement modes, then click the station and go into configuration mode. Oh, by the way, the station has also received a name, fully automatic. Let's change that name. This is our station South. And now configure this station. Look at these blue dots and this little bulldozer. I want to get rid of these platforms over here and the roof, and the blue dots, they depict where I can connect something. That something can be track or platform or buildings. Right now I want to place a couple of tracks, and then I go back to platforms because I now want to place the passenger platform over here. And well, let's put one roof on top of it. There we have it. This looks good. Configuration is done. Let's get out of here. And now what we need to do is connect the other tracks. That is not difficult. We just go over here and connect it. Take care that we have okay speeds. And that is all right. And now we go from the corner and connect this one. This looks good. If I look from the side, is this a feasible station? Well, this little S-curve in the middle, I would have liked to avoid it, but for the sake of time, let's not place this station again. This is what we have. Let's go to station North, where we need combined passenger and cargo. Alright, so this time let me first make this track up to the point where I want to place my station. Is it 120, then it is straight? Yes, that's okay. Now I have a track to connect a station to. Buildings, well, let's do this same two-track station because we are going to modify it after we placed it. It has received a name, Lahore, but well, we are going to make this station North and then configure it. And what we need to do is have four tracks, but with passenger terminals in between. So my passenger terminals are already at the correct spot, but I have to get rid of the building. And then I have to place some additional tracks. That's my cargo track over here and over there, and place a cargo platform. Then the cargo trains can stop over there. Well, what I could also do is make my cargo track a bit longer. Why not? Because that looks good. And then I can add another cargo platform, and then the cargo trains can be a bit longer if we like to. This is it. Now, well, now we have to take care that we can connect all the tracks to it. Let me get out of here. Let's see what we can do. Alright, two tracks to connect here at the north. Let's do the northmost track first and start it somewhere over here in the curve to make it as smooth as possible. That looks good. And now we should be able to get from here to that second track without any strange S-curves or what have you. This looks super smooth. Yeah, good enough. Let's go to the other end. At this station, this is end, this is a dead end, so we need to connect these three tracks. The middle track was our sort of starting point, so let me make that a bit longer in a straight line up to there. Then we should be able to make this curve. And that was a calculation that we already did. It was a speed of 50. And look, that curve is going over our drawing perfectly well. Connect it over there. go from already the curve to over there, and then make this little S-curve here, that should all be quite smooth. We have good speeds over there, that is looking good. Now the tightest curve that we are going to have is to reach this point over here. Maybe we should try to get out of this curve already over there. I don't know if that is going to work. No, that is not going to work. It sometimes can be a little bit of a puzzle. Oh, if I do it like this, we get reasonable speeds. It's a little bit of an S, but yeah, who minds? This looks good to me. I think we have done a good job in placing the station platforms and have the track go all around. What we forgot is to have a nice building. Oh, look, this station, it already knows from itself that it has a passenger and a cargo platform, so we can make both lines through that station. But I like to add a little bit of a building. Let's do that. Let's see where we can get we have to connect it probably to the cargo platform, but for our demo it doesn't mind. Let's also place a cargo building over here, and well, that is looking good, isn't it? Well, not exactly very good, but it is a oh, what did I do? I have to click over here to get it away. Yeah, this is looking like a perfectly nice station, isn't it? It's time to create some lines where we want the trains to drive, and then place some trains and drive. Maybe see you back in the next video, and in the meantime, have fun.